Okay. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. So my name is Iqmal Hakimi bin Abdul Jalil. So our group would like to present about the video assessment for the vehicle engine, which is the title is Gasoline Particulate Filters. So for the introduction, gasoline particulate filters are an emission after treatment device that was created to manage particle emissions from gasoline direct injection engines. By middle 2018, one GPF producer had provided 1 million GPF for the European market. The technology has attained a market penetration of at least 10% of gasoline cars. The literature contains an in-depth review of tactics and technology for reducing PM emission from gasoline engines to lower particle number emission from GDI automobiles. Gasoline particulate filters have been created. So that's all from me.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Muhammad Hilmi bin Zainuddin and I will continue for the theory of operation of this system. So, the gasoline particle filters are designed to remove particulate matter from the exhaust gas of gasoline direct injection engines, GDI. The unit is located next to the turbocharger, directly behind the engine. This enables it to warm up rapidly, which is beneficial since it requires heat to function well. Exhaust gases are driven through the filter, which heats and reduces the trapped soot particles, carbon monoxide, nitrous oxide, and hydrocarbon particulates into small amounts of carbon dioxide, nitrogen, and water. So the filter technology employs a honeycomb-shaped filter structure made from synthetic ceramic material. As exhaust gases flow past the filters, soot particles are captured, and when the exhaust temperature is high, the soot is burnt and the filter is regenerated. So that's all from me. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Khairul Fahmi bin Dahari. So this is my part. Four advantage of GPF, the most effectiveness under all operating conditions that include operation. GPF product particle numbers emission control under all engine operating conditions that we need for RDE testing. Next, GPF also can control emission from engine fault. The increasing PN emission can occur as a result of engine fault and malfunction, such as increased lube oil consumption. Besides, GPF also can control unregulated emission including polynuclear aromatic hydrocarbon for GDI engines. Even though equipped with three waste catalysts, it still may produce the significant levels of toxic emission. For this advantage of GPF, the system suitable for petrol vehicle instead of diesel vehicle. This is because diesel can block the particle filter cause of short journey with low speed. Besides, the system requires a space engine compartment that can make vehicle run and operate slowly. Next, GPF produce high fuel consumption and loss in performance cause of performance modification. Other things that are bad for GPF include poor servicing vehicle. Lastly, GPF only applicable at certain weather. It was good operating in the vehicles that equipped with GPF in colder climates. That's all from me. Thank you.
Assalamualaikum. My name is Muhammad Karuna Ibn Fauzi. I will continue about opinion and improvement of technology. As we know, passenger vehicle major air pollution contributor, producing a significant amount of nitrogen oxide, carbon monoxide and other pollution. Transportation contribute more than half of the carbon monoxide and nitrogen oxide, and almost quarter of the hydrocarbon emitted into our air. So by developing the technology, this emission problem can be controlled. Okay, next. GPF are expected to be used primarily in the European Union and in China to meet a particular number emission standard for gasoline passenger car and light commercial vehicle to reduce emission. By combining the other system and technology to control the emission like a catalytic converter, EGR, with GPF, it will drastically reduce the emission on the internal combustion engine. Okay, that's all.
Yes, assalamualaikum. My name is Ahmad Syahid Hakimi and I will end this presentation with conclusion. In conclusion, gasoline particulate filters are an emission after treatment technology based on diesel particulate filters, which is DPF, developed to control particulate emissions from gasoline direct injection engines. GPF control of emissions from engine fault, which is increased particle number. Emissions can occur as a result of engine faults and malfunctions such as increased lube oil consumption. Hence, this emission can be effectively controlled by particulate filters. Furthermore, GPF can control certain unregulated emission, including polynuclear aromatic hydrocarbons, PAH. GDI engine, even though equipped with three-way catalysts, may produce significant levels of toxic PAH emission. Thank you. That's all for me.